Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulihil karim, amma ba'd. Beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, wherever you may be, I pray that this message reaches each and every one of you with vibrant iman, as we always say, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects you, protects all your loved ones and us all from trials and tribulations, and Allah keeps us all with afiyah. A message to each and every one of you, and a reminder to myself, is the best gift that we can give to the best of Allah's creation, our beloved Habib Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam, on the best night, the best day of the week, is to increase and send an abundance of durood, or what we say, salat ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And in fact, this is a command of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself has said that inna Allah, undoubtedly Allah, wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Undoubtedly, indeed, Allah and his angels are continuously sending blessings, salutations upon Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allah says, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Allah addresses us by saying, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, 89 times in the Quran. And from these 89 times, Allah says, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. That, oh, you who have believed, ask Allah to send blessings upon him and peace. And when Allah Ta'ala, what does it mean that when Allah sends salawat, this is the mercy, the rahmah of Allah, and the salat of the angels, meaning their dua for Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and us as human beings, believers, when we send durood, it is our dua for him, and it is our thana, our praises upon our beloved Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Let us never forget the verse wherein Allah Ta'ala addresses his Habib, and Allah says, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ, that we've raised for you your remembrance, your mention. Allahu Akbar. When Allah Ta'ala said this, Allah said to his Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, إِذَا ذُكِرْتُ ذُكِرْتَ مَعِي, that when I will be mentioned, you will be mentioned with me. When we say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, immediately after the word Allah, La ilaha illallah, immediately the word, the name thereafter is the name of his Habib, the name of his beloved. Similarly, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu. Allahu Akbar. So, dear friends in Islam, on one instance, a great companion by the name of Ubay bin Ka'b radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said to our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that, ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, innani ukthiru salata alayka, fakam aja'alu laka min salati. He said to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that I send salutations in abundance, I send durood in abundance, how much time should I devote to sending durood salutations upon you? So our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that ma shi't, as much as you like. So Ubay radiallahu anhu says that I asked one quarter, a rubu'. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that whatever you wish, but if you do more, it will be better for you. So he asked Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one half. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whatever you wish, but if you do more, it will be better for you. Again he asked that two thirds of my time. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that whatever you wish, but the more you do, the better for you. Thereafter, Ubay bin Ka'b radiallahu anhu said that, أَجْعَلُ لَكَ صَلَاتِ كُلَّهَا, that I'll spend all my time. I'll spend all my time in sending durood upon you. So, upon this, what did our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? He said that, إِذَن تُكْفَى هَمَّكْ وَيُغْفَرُ لَكَ ذَنْبَكْ. If that's the case, you spend all your time in sending durood, then all your needs will be sufficed. Every one of your worries will be taken care of. And not only that, all your sins will also be forgiven by Allah. Allahu Akbar. And dear friends in Islam, a few other benefits of sending durood, as it is a Thursday night. Allahu Akbar. Our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that أكثروا أَكْثِرُوا مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ عَلَيَّ, that send abundance of durood upon me on a Thursday night and on the day of Friday, because your durood is presented before me. Similarly, our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَلَائِكَةً سَيَّاحِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, Allahu Akbar, that Allah has angels, and what is the responsibility of these angels? To go around this earth and to do what? To convey to me the salam of my ummah. Allahu Akbar. Whoever sends one durood upon Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends 10 upon him. Allahu Akbar. And in a sahih hadith of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that there's no one who sends salam upon me, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will restore to me my soul so that I may return his salam upon me. Allahu Akbar. Similarly, our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that awlan nas bi yawm al-qiyamah. Awlan nas bi yawm al-qiyamah. The closest of people will be to me on the day of Qiyamah, aktharuhum alayya salatan, those who send the most blessings, those who recite the most amount of durood upon me. And Imam Nawawi rahmatullah alayhi has mentioned that what does it mean, the closest, the nearest? It means those who are the most entitled to my intercession. And Allahu Akbar, similarly, Sayyidina Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu tell the people that dua is suspended between the heavens and the earth, and none of it is taken up until you send blessings, until you send durood upon your Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So with these few words, I encourage each and every one of you and myself as well, to let us all try and recite durood upon our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Any form of durood, even simply by saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or sallallahu ala nabiyil ummi. And the best of all is the durood, what we know as durood Ibrahim, which we recite in salah. Let us try and recite these words. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take care of all what worries and concerns us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. Allah ta'ala bless us with the intercession of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when we go into our graves, that we recognize Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and on the day of Qiyamah, that he recognizes us as his followers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our hearts with his love, with the love of his Nabi, with the love of Quran, with the love of those actions that Allah loves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who follow his Nabi and those who spend our lives in his obedience and in the obedience of his Habib. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.